Hello, here we are in the lab. What I'm going to do today is show you how we find some of the smaller artifacts here at Jamestown. What I'm going to show you today is a sample of material that came out of John Smith's well, James Fort's first well. And we excavated this well in 2009. We took all of the soil from it, put it through a water screening process, where we would take the soil, dump it onto a screen, push the dirt through a 1/8-inch mesh using water, and that material that would fall through the 1/8-inch mesh would land in a window mesh where we would collect these smaller items that I'm going to show you. What we do is we bring the material into the lab and we sort through it during a process that we call picking. You know, we've got gallons and gallons of this material, so just to give you an idea of how much volume we find, we've saved and archived here in the lab. I've got some soil here from a layer in the well, which was JR27188N, and you can just see, I mean, it's just, we've got probably millions of little objects in here. And what I'm going to do is scoop some out with this tray here, and then I'm going to put it on the photography copy table here, and we'll zoom in on the material and I'll show you what it looks like to find some of these artifacts amongst the material here. Okay, here we are now at the photography copy stand. I've put a penny in for scale. What I'm going to do now is zoom in on the area around the penny where I've placed a few artifacts that we've found in this material. Now, I'm going to take the penny out of the frame here and then see if you can see in the area around where the penny just was, there are a few artifacts that should be visible now. I'll give you a moment to see what you can find for yourself and then I'll pick the objects out. One of the objects you can see is up here in the top right hand corner, and it is a Venetian trade bead. It's blue glass right here. You can see it between the tweezers. We have found hundreds of those in this layer. We've also got it's a little bit more obvious here, is a crab claw to a blue crab. And there are literally thousands of these amongst the material. Well, we've also got fish scales. You can see a couple fish scales in the frame right in this area. Here's a little one right here. We've also got another bead right here between the tweezers, which is actually a shell bead that would likely be made by Virginia Indians. This right here is a lead droplet, probably waste from making lead shot. Right, so obviously you can see that we've got our work cut out for us. We've got a lot left to do here to sort through all of this. But I also wanted to add that there are special days with public programming out here where archaeologists and or archaeological volunteers work with the visitors. So, you know, the children and their parents oftentimes are very interested in this. They can go ahead, the public can go ahead and join us in picking through this material and sharing in the moment of discovery. While these smaller objects are not per se as eye-catching as some museum pieces you might see, they are still an important part of the story of what life was like here at James Fort during the early years of the colony.